lot of fences and built them right across our cattle ranges.
You dirty dirt scratchers, go back to Missouri, you belong.
Yeah. to need a gangpost.
You gotta be blind, you ain't supposed to know what girl goes with what hammer. Now, if your sweetheart told you that hers will be done up a certain way, with a certain color ribbon, that ain't my fault. That will start with the hammers around back and move on around front. Follow me.
Oh, hey there, young fella. I was just hoping to meet up with you.
Oh, it's you.
I think there's something we should discuss.
We only got one thing to talk about. Well, Mr. Joaquin, I hear you got yourself engaged to Ada Wayne.
Really?
Well, nothing. I don't know what to call you. You ain't skinny enough for a snake, you ain't pretty enough for a skunk. Too little to be a man, too big to be a mouse. I reckon you're wrecked.
That's illogical.
Answer me one question. Do you love her?
Well,
as if I thought you didn't, I'd tie you up in this here bag and drop you in the river. Are you serious about her?
Yes,
I'm serious. And do you worship the ground that she walks on like I do?
Yes.
Better say yes.
Yes, yes, yes.
The hell you do?
Yes.
Would you spend every cent you had for her? Because that's what I did. See that bag? Full presents. Cost me $50. All I had in the world.
And if you had that $50 cash?
I'd have Ada Wayne and you'd lose her.
I'd lose her, yes. Well, let's see what you got in here. I might want to buy something.
Well, what would you want with them?
I'm a peddler, ain't I? I buy and sell. I could pay you as much as... Well, a lot. Let's see. Ooh. What a lovely hot water bag. It looks fresh. Give you $8 for it.
$8? That would be honest. Only cost me $3.50.
Well, I said $8, and I mean $8. Ooh. Now, this here is a cracker jack, huh?
Well, take your hands off that! That was for a wedding night.
And don't bet you're so good. I'll give you $22.50.
$22? What time?
I said $22.50. Take it. Let's see what else you got. Ooh, what a lovely ankle brace.
That was for her to wear.
Didn't hardly think that was for you.
Mighty dainty.
I'll give you $15 for it. Let's see, that's 22 and 8 is 30, and then 15 is 45, and 50 is 45.50.
45.50? See, that's his most ass. You wanna buy some more?
Might.
Did you ever see one of these?
What made you buy something like this? You got it in for some money?
How'd you mean? It's just 20 pictures.
It's only a thing it is. It's more than that.
Where is everybody? Where's they know her?
On to the other side of the house, Laura. How much you give me for the thing?
Laura, where'd you run to?
I don't like to deal with things like this. It's too dangerous for me. Guess you really don't know what it is.
Sure do. Is this the girl in pink tights?
Hey, either of you two see Laura?
Just went to the other side of the house, Judd. Watch what's going on there.
Hey, Judd. There's one of them things you was looking for here. Let's go in there.
How much?
$3.50.
That's a lot of money. I can 90 might be worth it though.
All right, $3.50 from him, and $45.50 from you. Well, that makes $50, don't it?
Nope, $1 short.
Well, darn it, I must have figured wrong. How much for all the rest of the stuff in the bag?
$1.
Done. Now I got $50, don't I? Know what that means? It means I'm gonna take Ada Wayne back from you.
Now you wouldn't do a thing like that to me.
Oh, wouldn't I? And when I tell Paul who I got most of the money off of, maybe he'll change his mind about who's smart and who's dumb.
Well, you certainly bungled me, young man.
Matt, here's the last two hammers. Who's there? Ain't got nobody.
The little one's mine, and the one next to it's Lord's.
Well, that's the end of that secret.
Yeah.
24.
Snell, Slim, do I get six?
Ben.
Six bits?
6 bits! Anybody else? 6 bits ain't enough for looks like any man can make. Well, what about you, Mike? You won last year.
Yeah, that's right. Hey, Landy, you still got that same old sweet potato pie like last year?
You bet! Same old sweet potato pie, Mike. What do you say?
I say, you give me a 3-day bellyache.
Never mind about that. Now, who bit the dollar?
Ben!
Mine's the last bit, 6 bits.
I bet a dollar!
90 cents?
90 cents! Now we're getting rid of gentlemen! Another desk in the schoolhouse! Did I hear any more?
You're here $50!
$50! Nobody ever said $50 on the lunch! Why, nobody ever did 10!
He ain't got $50!
Oh, yes, I have! And if you're a man of honor, you gotta say Anna Winnie belongs to me like you said she would.
Where's your money?
Right here in my hand!
But that ain't yours! You just bid it all to the schoolhouse. Gotta say the peddler man shook it to my daughter's hand.
Now wait a minute, that ain't fair.
$50, going.
$51.
You're crazy?
$51 and $2.
Hey, Will, shut up.
Now wait a minute. If I don't bid anymore, I can still keep my money, can't I?
Sure can.
Well, then I still got $50. Well, this is mine.
You feeble-minded sight poke!
Going for $51. Going. That means Anna Wendy gets the prize, I guess.
And I get Anna Wendy.
And what are you getting for $51?
A 3-day bellyache.
Belongs to my niece. Took a peek inside it earlier and it looks mighty tasty. What right here, gents?
2 bits!
2 bits?
4 bits, right here, Anna.
4 bits! Slim, what about you? 6?
I bet a dollar.
Now, dollar, that's more like it. Did I hear 2?
$1.25.
$2?
$2.50.
$3!
And 2 bits?
$3 and 4 bits.
$4.
And 2 bits.
I got a bid for $4 and 2 bits. Ain't I gonna hear any more? I got a bid for $4 and 2 bits. Well, are you gonna let him have it?
4.5.
4.5. Going.
$4.75.
Come on, gentlemen. Schoolhouse ain't built yet. We still gotta get a nice chimney.
$5.
$5. Going.
And 2 bits.
Ah, too rich for my blood. I can't afford no more.
5 1/4. Ate for a lunch with cold duck and stuffing and lemon meringue pie.
$6.
$6, going.
And 2 bits.
Hi, Jen. Sure are stubborn. Mr. Carnes is a richer man than you. And I know how he likes custard with raspberry syrup. Yeah. Anybody else got a bid?
No, they all dropped out.
Can't you see?
You got enough, don't you, Heller?
Let's get on.
Here's the money.
Now, wait a second. I ain't said going yet.
Say it.
I got a bid. Just right. For $6 and a quarter. Going.
Did you say it was getting Larry?
Just right.
Well, and for how much?
6 1/4.
That's not quite enough now, is it?
It's more than you got.
Got a saddle here, cost me $30.
You can't bid saddles.
It's gotta be cash.
$30 saddle must be worth something to somebody.
Oh, you get 10 for it.
Don't be a fool, boy. You can't even lose that saddle.
You got cash?
Right here in my pocket.
Well, let's not waste time now. How are you going?
How are you? No matter what.
Well, you know, I'm gonna bid all this $10 that Tom just gave me.
Alright, $10, going, going,
and
going!
And 2 bits.
Really?
Y'all know my horse, Dunn? Kind of a nice horse, well broke.
I'll give you 25 for Dunn.
So, and that makes my bid $35.
Curly, you're crazy. But it's all for a schoolhouse, all for learning and educating, right? $35, going.
Hold on.
I ain't finished bidding. You just put up all you got in the world, didn't you? Except the clothes on your back, because they ain't worth nothing.
You can't bid your gun, because you need that.
Yeah, you need that bad.
So, Aunt Ellen,
just as reckless as Curly McLean, I guess. Just as good as getting what I want. I'm going to bid all I got in the world.
All I say, 2 years doing farm work.
All for lower.
So here it is. $42.31. Anybody want to buy a gun? You, Joe. Buy the new last Thanksgiving.
Please, Curly, don't sell your gun.
Give you $18 for it.
Sold. And now that makes my bid $53. Anybody going any higher?
Go, go, go. Well, ain't anybody gonna cheer? Dum diddy dum dum dum.
Oh, the farmer and the cabin should be friends. Oh, the farmer and the cabin should be friends.
Hey! Well, that's the idea. The cowman and the farmer should be friends. Now, he lost the bidding, but the bidding was fake. All right, cowman, shake the farmer's hand.
Sure, I'll shake hands. No more feelings, Carly.
That's better.
Say, Curly, I want to show you something. Excuse us, Lori. You ever see one of these? Just what is that? Well, it's something special.
You just look through it right there, see?
Curly! Curly, what you doing?
Doing nothing much. What do you want to squeal at a man like that for? Just get a little daylight out of it.
Well, stop looking at those old French pictures and ask me for a dance. You were going to this party, didn't you?
Sure, I'll dance with you, crazy woman. Dance you all over this matter.
Sam, pick that banjo to pieces.
Now and then, no half and half romance will do. Take me like I am or leave me be. If you can't give me all, give me nothing. And nothing's what you get from me.
Not even something.
Nothing's what you get. See, last time I see you alone, it was winter.
Snow was 6 inches in drifts, and I was sick. You bring me that hot soup out to the smokehouse,
me in bed. I hadn't shaved in 2 days. And you asked me if I had any fever, and
put your hand on my head to see.
I remember.
Do you?
But you don't remember as much as I do.
I remember everything you've ever done. Every word you've ever said. Do you see? You see how it is?
I see. Not good enough, am I? I'm a hard hand. Got dirt on my hands.
A big slut! Ain't fitting to touch you, am I?
you're such a fine lady and all. Yeah, we'll see how fine you are. Then you wish you weren't so free with your ass.
Are you threatening me? Are you standing there trying to tell me if I don't love you, love over me like a whole way to do something about it? Why, you're nothing but a mean dog and somebody ought to shoot you. You think so much about being hard-handed. Well, I'll just tell you something that'll rest your brain, Mr. Judd. You ain't a hard hand for me no more. You can just pack your nose and scoot. Oh, and I ain't got better ideas than that. You ain't to come on the place again, you hear me? I'll send your stuff any place you say, but don't you so much as set foot inside the pasture gate, or I'll stick the dogs on you!
You said you're safe. You brought it on yourself. I can't help it. I can't never rest. I told you the way it was. And you wouldn't listen!
Seen Ada Wayne? She's going in.
Will, could you do something for me? Go and find Curly and tell him I'm here. I want to see Curly awful bad. I gotta see him.
Why'd you turn around and look, you crazy woman?
Curly!
Well, you found yours. I gotta go hunt for mine.
Now what on earth is ailing the Bella Claremore? My gum, if you ain't crying.
Curly, I'm afraid. I'm afraid of my love.
Great Lord.
Don't you leave me.
God Almighty.
Don't mind me crying, I can't help it.
Cry your eyes out.
Oh, I don't know what to do.
Here, I'll show you. About all the men to handle in public. Wait a second. You get away from me. You stay right away from me.
You don't like me, Curly?
I don't like you.
Curly, sit on the couch!
As cold as a hunk of ice.
Mr. Birdhole on your pants.
Listen, you stay over there and I'll stay right over here and you tell me what you want with me.
Well, Jeb was here. He scared me. He's crazy. I ain't ever seen nobody like him. He was talking wild, and he threatened me. So I fired him. I wish I wouldn't have. There ain't no telling what'll do now.
Well, that's just it. You fired him. Tomorrow we'll go down and get you a new hired hand. I'll even stay in the place you were scared of that hound dog. I quit your belly aching, and I'll spank you. Listen, while I think of it, what do you think about marrying me?
Gracious, what I want to marry you for?
Don't you think you can maybe think of a reason why you might?
Can't think of none right now, are
you? Don't marry me, ma'am, please. I don't know what I'm going to do if you don't.
Curly, well, I'll marry you if you want me to.
I'll be the happiest man's life as soon as we're married. I gotta learn to be a farmer. Well, I see that. Been thinking about throwing the rope and getting my hands blistered in a new way. Oh, things is changing right and left. I gotta buy up mowing machines and cut down the prairie. Shoe them horses and drag them way out into the sun. They're gonna make a state in this territory. Put it in the Union. Country's a change, we gotta change with it. Bring up a couple of boys and a new stock to keep up with the way things is going in this crazy world. I got you to help me. I'll amount to something yet. Say, I remember the first time I ever saw you. It was at the county fair, and you was riding a gray filly. And I says to someone, hey, who's this cute little thing with a bang hanging down on my forehead?
Yeah, I remember. You were riding drunk that day.
That's right.
And one of them threw you.
That is a man, Kid, that loves you like nothing ever loved nobody.
Oh, Ollie.
A man who will stick by you. And that man for you is Will Parker.
Huh. I like Will a lot.
Well, you should. He's young and handsome, strong like an ox.
I love my right, I guess.
Yes, you do. You love those glistening brown eyes of his and the way his mouth will wrinkle up when he smiles.
Do you love him too?
I love him because he will make my Edoani happy. Now, it's time for me to say goodbye. Let me show you how we say goodbye in my country. A Persian goodbye, if you will. Goodbye. 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 Goodbye.
That was goodbye.
You know, in my country, we have a saying. One goodbye is never enough. Now, goodbye. 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 I am so glad you are to marry such a fine fellow as this Will Parker. He will treat you well.
Hello, Will! All he had been was just saying goodbye.
I want to say goodbye to you, too.
Oh, no, you don't. I just saw the last one.
Well, you two have made for each other. Now, you be good to her, and you better be good to him. Now, you don't mind that friend of the family, you know. I'm just going to...
Did you say you was going?
Yes, I'm afraid I must, you know. Lonely gypsy hit the open road, but before I go, let me show you how we say goodbye in my country. Persian goodbye. 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 Well, you're such a lucky fellow. Wish it were me she was marrying instead of you.
It don't seem to make no difference, hardly.
You know, lonely gypsy better hit that open road. Goodbye.
You ain't gonna think of that old peddler man anymore, are you?
Well, of course not. Never think of no one unless it is with me.
Well, then I'm never gonna leave your side.
Well, even if you don't, even if you never go on a trip or nothing, can't you once in a while give me one of them Persian goodbyes?
Persian goodbye? Well, that ain't nothing compared to an Oklahoma hello.
Hello, Will!
Getting drunk with us.
I've
never seen you stay so sober at a wedding party.
I've been scared. I've been scared of Judd Fry to come up and start with Curly.
Judd Fry's been out of the territory for 3 weeks.
No, he's back. Yeah, I seen him at Claremore's the other day. Drunk as a lord.
Well, there's that happy couple. Let's give 3 cheers for him, everybody! Yip, yip!
Hooray!
Yip, yip!
Hooray!
Yip, yip!
Hooray!
Well, look at this! She's got a girl's bouquet!
All right, everybody! It's time for the family outfit! 3, 2, 1! Great job, everybody! So, Kirk, was he scared when the preacher said that about you taking a ceremony?
Well, I was scared he wasn't gonna say it.
I was afraid Curly back out on me.
They couldn't pick a better time to start in life.
Curly had it too late.
Starting as a farmer with a brand new wife.
farm, they give you barley, carrots, potatoes,
pasture for the cattle,
the Spanish and some mares,
flowers on the prairie where the June bugs zoo,
plenty of room to swing a rope, behind the rain. Oh, oh, every night, my honey lamb and I sit alone and talk and watch a hawk making lazy circles in the sky. We know we belong to the land, and know that we belong to his brand. And when we say,
yeah,
honey, by the yeah.
Business.
Where's that curly-headed boy of yours?
With a dimple on his chin.
Oh. Now be careful with him.
What you doing?
Party's still going on? Glad I ain't too late. I got a present for the group. First, I will kiss the bride.
Hey, come on.
Come on.
All right, guys.
Well, you found his own knife. You seen it, didn't you?
Roll him over, somebody!
No, no, don't touch him!
Hey, whoa, what happened? Don't you touch him!
See, the knife had it happen!
He's all right, Andy. What'd we do? Just stunned?
Get away, Sonia. Let me look at it.
Curly, is he?
Don't say nothing.
King B!
I didn't go to!
King B! Like that to happen to us?
Can't do a thing now. Get him to a doctor. I don't know.
Take him over to my ring, everybody! I'll try him over to Dr. Tyler!
Quick, I'm afraid it's too late!
Take him easy. Don't shake him. Listen, I'm gonna go see if anything can be done for him. Take care of her, Anna.
Maybe it's better if you approach him away than that.
I don't see why this had to happen. When everything was so fun!
Don't let your mind run on it, dear.
But I can't forget it, I tell you. I never will.
Well, Laura, dear, if you can't forget it, don't cry to you, honey. Oh, lots of things happen to folks. Sickness, or being poor and hungry, or even being old and afraid to die. That's the way it is. Cradle to grave. And you can stand it. There's one way. You gotta be tough. You gots to be. You can't enjoy the sweet and tender in life unless you're tough.
I wish that was the way you are.
Oh, fiddlesticks! Scrawny and old, you couldn't hire me to be the way I am.
Oh, you're such a crazy.
You want more.
They're taking Judd over to Dave Tyler's till morning.
Is he alive?
Listen, Lori, this is Cordell. Here's a federal marshal. He thinks it's best that I give myself up. Tonight.
Tonight?
Your train leaves for Claremore in 20 minutes.
The best thing is for Curly to go off on his own accord and tell the judge.
Well, Andrew, you're the judge, ain't you?
Well, yeah, but I...
Well, tell him now and get it over.
Well, you can't do that. That just wouldn't be proper.
Well, let's just do it here and say we did it in court.
But you can't do that. That's breaking the law.
Well, let's not break the law. Let's just bend it a little bit.
Hey, Andrew, Cord, we can do it right. We can do it right here. Cord, we can do it right here.
Think about this.
I'm thinking, Cord, we
can. Now, Andrew,
I saw your trap. We can give the boy a fair trial without locking him up on his wedding night. Now, here's the long and short of it. I got to ask you what's your plea. That means, why'd you do it?
Why'd I do it? Because he was pestering Laura.
Ah, just wait a minute. And don't let your tongue wobble around in your mouth like that. Just answer my question. What happened tonight that made you kill him?
We told you it was a knife, and...
And you had to defend yourself, didn't you?
That's right, and furthermore...
Ah, never mind the furthermores. The police self-defense.
What is that?
Quiet! Now, did anybody see this happen?
I seen it.
They sure did.
Self-defense, all right.
Try to stab with the frog sticker.
I feel funny about this, Andrew. Feel funny.
You'll feel funny when I'm telling your wife you've been messing around with another woman.
Now, I ain't messing around with no one.
Maybe not, but you sure feel funny when I tell your wife, dear.
Marshal, we ain't gonna let you send the boy to jail on his wedding night. We just ain't gonna let you, so just shut up.
Yeah!
Hey, I got an idea. Why don't we take him to the station on Curly, Surrey? Then we'll be the horses.
Yeah!
Now, I ain't even said the verdict yet.
The
verdict's not guilty, ain't it?
Well, of course, but...
Well, then say it!
Not guilty!
Court adjourned!
Well, Ada Annie, where have you two been?
Will and me had a misunderstanding, but he explained it fine.